Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss how to measure the performance of investment centers using return on investment. We'll start off by getting an understanding of what both investment centers and return on investment are. Next, we'll develop an understanding of how to use return on investment to measure performance, using a specific example to tie it all together. The ability to accurately measure a company's performance is critical for both managers and investors. So let's get started. Imagine you made two investments. Investment A earned you $100, and investment B earned you $500. Which one was the better investment? Well, it might seem like the answer is B. This is not necessarily the case. What if you had to invest substantially more money in investment B in order to earn that $500? That means you are putting more money at risk with this investment. In order to make a better assessment, managers and investors use the return on investment metric to help measure the actual performance of the investment. One of the most common ways managers and investors measure the actual performance of investment centers is to calculate the division's return on investment, which is the amount of profit earned for each dollar of investment. When it comes to the generic formula for return on investment, the formula is to take the net return generated from the investment and divide it by the original cost of the investment and then express this as a percentage. For example, if an investor received a return of $10,000 on a $100,000 investment, the return on investment would be 10%. This concept can be applied to divisions within a company that are structured as investment centers. Investment centers are individual business units or divisions within a company that have the freedom to invest capital in order to generate profit for the business. Investment centers are given control over their capital, which allows them to choose how they'd like to invest it. For example, a division of an automobile manufacturer may choose to invest in new automated manufacturing equipment with the intention of generating profit. In this case, an effective way to measure performance would be based on how much profit they generated in relation to the amount that they had invested in these capital assets. When business units are set up as investment centers, every dollar they expend on operating assets that they use to generate operating income would be considered an investment. The calculation for return on investment in this type of scenario is operating income divided by average operating assets. Operating income is the profit that the company has earned from selling their products or services before factoring in any interest and taxes. This would be calculated by taking the revenue generated less the operating expenses of the business unit. Operating assets are all of the resources that the company has purchased and put to use in the business with the intention of generating income. Things like equipment, land, and buildings. To calculate the average operating assets, we would just take the company's beginning asset value at the start of the period, plus the ending value, and divide it by 2. This gives us an understanding of the average value of their assets over the span of that accounting period. For example, say a company had $100,000 of operating income 1 year. Their operating assets were worth $300,000 at the start of the year, and $500,000 at the end of the year. To calculate return on investment, first, we would calculate their average operating assets, which is beginning assets plus ending assets divided by 2, or $300,000 plus $500,000 divided by 2, which equals $400,000. Now we can calculate return on investment by taking their operating income and dividing it by the average operating assets that we just calculated. To do this, we would take the $100,000 of operating income, divide it by the $400,000 of average operating assets, and express it as a percentage of their average operating assets for a total of 25%. This means that for each dollar invested, the company earned 25 cents in profit. Using return on investment as a tool to measure performance comes with some advantages to the business. By evaluating managers not only on their bottom line profitability, but also on their ability to generate returns, it encourages managers to focus on both cost efficiency as well as operating asset efficiency. Managers will be motivated to control costs since this will improve their operating profit, which is a key part to the return on investment calculation. At the same time, they'll be motivated to invest their money wisely in assets that are likely to generate healthy returns. However, with that said, it's a common misconception that return on investment is the only useful approach to evaluating the performance of investment centers. There's a few disadvantages to placing too much emphasis on this return on investment calculation. The first is that it can create an environment where profitability of individual business units is prioritized at the expense of the profitability of the overall company. Business units may choose to invest in projects that give them a stronger return on investment result in that period, instead of investing in a project that would have brought more straight profit for the organization as a whole. The second is that it can motivate management of individual business units to prioritize the results of the short run over the long run. In order to obtain higher return on investment numbers in a particular period, management can try to game the system by cutting corners to reduce costs, thereby increasing profitability in that period. This could lead to long-term issues, such as quality concerns, that could come back to create problems in the future. As a result, it's important to keep both these constraints in mind when companies determine the metrics they use to evaluate performance. Let's take a look at an example of how return on investment can help a company evaluate which one of their departments is operating most effectively. The CEO of the company is looking at the operating results of Division A and Division B at the end of the year as follows. Division A had operating profit of $300,000, while Division B only had $100,000 in operating profit. In this case, it appears that Division A had stronger performance since they generated 3 times more operating profit. But let's look at the full picture so that we can calculate their return on investment. If we factor in their average operating assets, it tells a little bit of a different story. Division A had average operating assets of $3 million, while Division B's average operating assets were only $250,000. If we take the operating profit of $300,000 and $100,000 respectively, and divide it by the average operating assets of $3 million and $250,000 respectively, we can see that the return on investment for each division is now clear. In this case, even though Division A generated more profit, we can see that they were only able to bring in a 10% return on that investment, while Division B was able to generate a much stronger 40% return on their investment. Therefore, in this case, the CEO can conclude that Division B appears to be the more efficient investment center in this period. And that brings us to the end of this video. Remember, in order for organizations to be successful in the long run, they need an effective way to measure the performance of their business units. Return on investment allows them to focus on maximizing both profitability and operating asset efficiency. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.